everybody. Welcome back to Huey's Tackle. Tonight we're going to do a real scale shad pattern I've been doing. First I started off with the white base, then I went with the white pearl, heat set all that, then I went ahead and meshed it in my little rings I use, and next I'm going to put down some pearl silver. When I spray this, we're going to spray at an angle from the front. We're only going to do that silver on half the body. When I'm painting, I got two 1.5s, and two flicker shads. Alright, now we're going to heat set these. Alright, next I've got some of this gold FW ink loaded. And what we're going to do with this, we're going to shoot from the back like this over the shoulders. Alright, we're gonna heat set this. Next, we got the Wicked Detail Sepia. We're gonna do the same thing and just spray it over where we put this gold here and just leave a little gold showing at the bottom. I like getting it dark over the back of the shoulders. You don't have to, it's just your preference on how dark you want it. Alright, now we're going to heat set these real quick. Alright, next I've got some of this Golden High Flow Carbon Black. And what we're going to do is make a line from the tail to the cheek. Darken this little one up some more. Right now we'll heat set. Alright, next we got some sepia loaded back in. We're gonna unwrap these. All these are like the little hair clips you can find in like the section and stuff where the hair brushes are. I like using these better than magnets. I just use the magnets to keep the tops held down. All right. I'm gonna take this sepia and darken this back and a little bit around the eyes. This one is an original flicker shad. The other one is a one I bought offline where I normally buy my blanks. Something in that one. There we go. New knitting I just put in, I always leave some fuzz the first couple of times, so I always gotta make sure you get it off. All right, now we're gonna heat set this real fast. All right, next I've got some fluorescent, what's that? Sunburst. We're just gonna hit the throat because pretty much after this, the black will do on the back of the dot. And that'll be almost it. So we're just gonna add a little bit right here to the throat. Alright, now we're gonna heat set these. Alright, I got some carbon black loaded in. And we'll go right over the back here. Get that nose around the eyes. Pretty much just spraying straight over the back and let the overspray drop down to darken it up some. Alright, now we'll heat set these real fast. Alright, next I've got them laid out. I've got this Anarchy model stencil. We're gonna put some little black dots towards the end of the tail here. I had to move my camera so I could get these baits laid out. All we're doing is adding some little black dots like that. If y'all like this camera angle better, let me know. I can start using it. I usually just put it in front of me, but I just bought this clamp with a flexible arm, so I can put it in a couple of different places now to get y'all some better camera shots. All right, now I'm gonna put these back in the little helping hands here. All right, forgot to add the shad dye, so we're gonna do that real quick before I put them on the stand. Still got that black loaded in, and we're just gonna go right above that line we just put down earlier. This pattern's one of my favorite patterns. I use it a lot. Had a lot of luck on it. I plan on painting some of these up and taking to the tournament with me this weekend. Some for the fundraiser and some to sell. Because I'll donate some to them while I'm there for their charity raffles. Try to help get them some money. I think this little bitty one here is gonna catch some good fish. Haven't done any this small yet. I think that's gonna be a good one. This is going to Isaac, he was my very first YouTube subscriber, so I'm giving this to him. Just a little thank you and a give back for being my first subscriber. So I hope he likes that one. I believe it. That's his. Took me a while to find one of those. Throw these back in here. All right, next I'm gonna add the purple down the back. You can achieve this a couple different ways. I use this Inspire Purple Pearl, but you can use either this Wicked Colors, the highlight purple. You can use that as well. Or if you have neither one of those, you can just use a basic pearl plum. But the Inspire to me just stands out a little better. All we'll do is just spray this straight over the back. It'll gradually turn to purple. To me that looks a lot better than those other two in my opinion. And you get the Inspire at CustomPaints.com. It's the only place I found it. Spray Gunner used to have it, and they discontinued it or stopped carrying it there. Because Inspire, they also make this Inspire H2O paints. It's pretty good. All right, now we're gonna heat set these. All right, once we did all that, it's done. So once it's done, it's gonna look something like this. And I'm telling this pattern here will produce fish probably just about all over the country. Y'all stay tuned for more. I plan to have some more videos uploaded here soon. Thanks everyone for watching.